You don't have to be a nuclear physicist to know that fusion is a complicated topic. But as Ben Tracy explains, it could also be the next big thing in clean energy.
This looks very impressive. What exactly is this?
This is the engine of the Starship Enterprise.
You could fool me, I'd believe that.
If this looks like the set of some Hollywood sci-fi show, perhaps that's fitting, because what they're doing here is making stars on Earth.
That is absolutely right. We are able to make miniature stars because fusion is the same reaction that powers the sun and the stars.
Tammy Ma leads the Fusion Energy Initiative at the National Ignition Facility, or NIF, in Livermore, California. It's part of the same government laboratory that ensures the safety and reliability of the nation's nuclear stockpile.
Every time we do a fusion experiment on the NIF, we are actually the hottest place in the entire solar system, hotter than the center of the sun.
Hotter than the center of the sun.
Hotter than the center of the sun.
I noticed a word over on the equipment over there. It says Dante.
Yes.
Is that a kind of a play on this is hotter than hell?
It is.
I mean, it's kind of mind-blowing when you say that, to think that that's what's going on here.
Humans are amazing, aren't we?
Yes.
And the humans here are using the largest laser ever built. It's 1,000 times more powerful than the entire U.S. electrical grid and is housed in this massive room.
How big is this room full of lasers?
It is the size of 3 U.S. football fields side by side, or about the size of a large football stadium.
192 laser beams travel nearly a mile and then focus in on a tiny target or a fuel pellet, smaller than a peppercorn. When the lasers hit the pellet, the atoms fuse together, releasing energy in the process.
Would you like to hold one?
Sure. It's that tiny.
Yeah, that little fuel pellet is about 2 millimeters in diameter.
But the consequences could be huge. Fusion would theoretically provide a nearly limitless source of clean and safe energy, powering our world without the fossil fuels that are warming the planet and contributing to climate change. It would make energy-intensive technologies like vertical farming and water desalination much cheaper, potentially solving the world's food and water problems.
It is completely clean. There's no carbon anywhere in the equation. There's no high-level nuclear waste. You can place fusion power plants nearly anywhere. It could help meet all of the energy needs for the U.S. now and into the future, even as our energy needs rise.
Fusion is a process that merges atoms together and releases more energy than fission, which splits atoms apart. Fission is used by today's nuclear power plants and creates hazardous nuclear waste. Fusion does not, but fusion is hard. After 60 years of research by scientists at NIF, they finally generated a reaction that produced more energy than it consumed. The breakthrough in 2022, crucial to ever creating a fusion power plant, made headlines around the world. Humans had unlocked the power of the stars.
This is the first time this has ever been demonstrated by humans here on Earth.
And that is what ignition is?
That is ignition, more energy out than we put in with the lasers.
So you put the eye in NIF.
We finally put the eye in NIF, that's right.
They have achieved ignition several times since then, and now the race is on to generate enough energy to consistently power a commercial fusion plant.
So this is where the fusion will take place?
Yep, so this is the room where we'll build the machine that actually makes the fusion.
The room where it happens.
Bob Mumgard is CEO and co-founder of Commonwealth Fusion Systems outside of Boston, one of more than 24 fusion startups getting billions of dollars in funding from the government and investors.
And that's from investors who look and say, yeah, it's going to take time, it's going to take work, but this is the birth of an industry.
Instead of lasers, Commonwealth uses a cloud of superheated plasma that burns at around 180 million degrees Fahrenheit, held in place by massive magnets that the company actually manufactures on site.
And so how strong are these magnets that can hold something like that in place?
The magnets in this machine will be the strongest magnets in the world, the magnets that could lift up an aircraft carrier.
Commonwealth expects to complete its demonstration reactor next year. It just announced plans to build its first full-scale power plant in Virginia, but that won't deliver energy to the grid until sometime next decade.
So this isn't an experiment just to say, gee whiz, we can actually do this. This is a process designed to lead to an actual power plant.
Yeah, that's right. If we added a few more parts and made it a little bit bigger, that would be the basis of a commercial power plant. This is the penultimate step to that.
Critics like to point out that fusion power has been an ever-elusive holy grail, always 20 to 30 years away. But startups like Commonwealth say this time is different. The technology is advancing as fast as the need for clean energy is rising. Stars aligning in the quest to create stars here on Earth.
Is it possible that we're the closest we've ever been, but we're still quite far away?
This is not a paper exercise for us. We're putting this machine together, we're buying the parts, we're machining the parts, and it's all coming together at the exact time that the world really needs something like this. I think that's a really cool story.